On New South Wales' highest day of Delta variant transmission,
77 locally acquired cases,
Sydney's new COVID battleground was clear.
The vast majority continue to be from southwestern Sydney.
The case numbers in southwestern Sydney are extraordinarily high.
More than 50 of the new cases have been identified in Sydney's southwest, as was the first death of the Delta outbreak, a woman in her 90s who passed away yesterday at Liverpool Hospital.
Regrettably, that person did acquire it within the household or within the home setting.
That tragedy driving home the main causes of the spread, attributed to both family visits.
We know transmission is going through households, from household to household.
And those classified as essential workers.
Like tradies who are visiting multiple sites.
While most people are said to be doing the right thing, many are still refusing to obey health orders.
One of those instances was a unit at Marrickville where police found 15 men in a small unit playing cards.
And as Sydney grapples with its spiralling COVID crisis, worse numbers are predicted.
And I'll be shocked if it's less than 100 this time tomorrow.
New South Wales Transport Minister Andrew Constance joins us now. Andrew, can we start with this tragic news of the 90-year-old who passed away yesterday? We're learning that this person wasn't vaccinated because, quote, they didn't have the opportunity. Can you explain to us exactly what not having the opportunity means for a 90-year-old?
It was the target of the vaccine program was to target the most at risk in our community. And someone at the age of 90 is an example of someone who was most at risk. And, you know, I think everybody's heart goes out to that family. You know, in terms of where we've been and what we saw with Victoria last year, where they lost 800 lives, you know, we've got to make sure that those who are most vulnerable, regardless of whether they're living at home alone or what have you, that they are getting that support to get the vaccine. And
okay, but
without knowing the specifics of this case, I mean, it is just, you know, again, an example with 9% of us in our community who are currently vaccinated. That number is way too low. It doesn't matter.
But Andrew, to make sure that this doesn't happen again, we need to know the specifics so that this not having an opportunity doesn't happen again. How many more are out there who are going to slip through the cracks and possibly die?
Well, Lisa, I can tell you from home here, I live in regional New South Wales. Everyone knows that. But, you know, people have been only able to go through their local GP, and there hasn't been that many GPs that have been able to even offer the AstraZeneca in a lot of regional areas. So there is a large cohort of people, regardless of their age, who are not vaccinated right now. And this is the key thing. We're so desperate to see the vaccines arrive so that we can get everybody vaccinated. And unfortunately, you know, what we're seeing today is so incredibly sad, given how we've gone as a country, how we've gone as a state relative to the rest of the world.
Minister, the Premier refused to say whether the lockdown would lift on Friday. On current numbers, it's really hard to see how that'll happen. So why won't the government just give more certainty and say it, tell people what's going to happen?
Because, to be honest with you, and I'm genuine in this belief, we don't know. I think the thing is that the next 72 hours, if we don't start to see these numbers go in the right direction, you know, government is being honest when it's saying right now we can't give you that certainty.
I think everybody in their heart of hearts, do you really think that the lockdown will lift this Friday, given that the Premier has said that she's anticipating more than 100 cases tomorrow? How could it possibly lift on Friday?
I think everybody knows that it's not going to lift on Friday based on these existing numbers. I think everyone knows that.
Then say it. Shouldn't she just come out and say it? Because people need certainty. They need to plan their lives. They need to know what's going to happen week after next. Why doesn't she just come out and say that?
Because I think what Gladys will do is be definite in her information when she gets the right advice in the next 72 hours about it. And, you know, that's where it's difficult, and I understand what you're saying in terms of that lack of surety, but we are dealing with something that has never been dealt with before. It is, you know, this is a variant of the virus where you just have to walk into someone's breathing space and you can get it. So hopefully, and fingers crossed, that in the next 72 hours, we start to get the numbers in terms of community transmission back to where we need it to be, and that's towards zero.
Andrew Constance, thanks so much for your time tonight.
Thanks, guys.
I think we're none the clearer on whether the lockdown is going to lift this Friday. We just heard the minister say that, well, we don't know, but then in another breath say that, well, I think everyone knows that we're probably not going to get out of lockdown this Friday. So
I don't understand why Gladys Berejiklian won't just bite the bullet on this and say there's no way we'll come out of lockdown by Friday. I mean, she's the Premier who said to us, we can all be adults, we all know how to do the right thing. Well, it turns out if you don't have clear enough messaging, people weren't doing what she described as the right thing, but wouldn't be clear on what the right thing actually was.
Yeah, I think you know what it is for me partly is just kind of mentally preparing to be in a slightly longer lockdown rather than going week to week not really knowing. At least just having that preparation there would be really helpful.
She's struggling to admit long lockdowns are ahead of us, I think, because she was the one that was so anti-lockdowns.
Yeah. True. All right, we'll be back right after the break. Don't go anywhere.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed. From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.